Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about Orsatz apparatus. Orsatz apparatus is used for analysis of flue gas. Flue gas means it is a waste gases after the combustion process that is coming out from the chimney. It is essential to analyze the flue gas because we must know whether the combustion is complete or not. If the combustion is complete, then the product will be generally carbon dioxide. If there is carbon, it will be converted into carbon dioxide. If there is hydrogen, it will be converted into water. If there is sulfur, it will be converted into SO2 and so on. Now, if the combustion is not complete, then carbon will react with oxygen to form carbon monoxide, not the carbon dioxide. It means that if there is carbon monoxide present in the flue gas, it means that there is incomplete combustion or there is short supply of oxygen. If the flue gas contains oxygen, excess amount of oxygen, it means that we have given excess of oxygen supply during the combustion process. Large amount of carbon dioxide indicates there is complete combustion of the fuel. Now, by using the Orsatz apparatus, we can calculate the amount of carbon dioxide, oxygen, carbon monoxide, and the nitrogen. But water, ash, and SO2 cannot be considered. Now, let us discuss how we are going to do the process. This is the equipment. This is the Orsatz apparatus. In this Orsatz apparatus, it consists of a leveling bottle connected to a burette by means of rubber tubing. By changing the position of this water reservoir, we can change the level of water present in the burette. This burette is surrounded by a water jacket tube containing water. It is surrounded by a water jacket. This is connected to a set of three absorption bulbs through stopbox. This is absorption bulb one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. And all these three bulbs will have different stopbox. This will have another different stopbox. This is a bulb. This will have other stopcock, and this one will have another stopcock. The first bulb contains potassium hydroxide solution and it has a capacity to absorb carbon dioxide. The second bulb contains alkaline pyrogallol solution which can absorb carbon dioxide and oxygen both. And this third bulb contains ammonical cuprous chloride solution. This can absorb all the three gases, that is carbon dioxide, oxygen, and carbon monoxide. At the end of the tube, there is a three-way stopcock. This three-way stopcock is opened in three different directions. One to the main apparatus, another to the atmosphere, and third to the U-tube through which the flue gas will be coming. This U-tube is filled with fused calcium chloride so that it can absorb water. So we'll be sending dry flue gas for the analysis. That is, removal of water will be done at this stage itself. So here the dried flue gas will be sent for the analysis. The three-way stopcock is at first open to the atmosphere and the water reservoir is raised to fill the water in the burette. By doing this, the air or any gas present in this apparatus will be expelled out through this stopcock, that is open to the atmosphere. After that, the gas, flue gas, dried flue gas will be sucked into the tube, and this process will be repeated about 3 to 4 times so that we'll ensure that the atmospheric gas present that may be present in this will be removed completely, or it will be removed almost in negligible amount, which is of almost nil amount will be present. Now, water level is at first adjusted so that the gas present in the graduated burette is 100 ml. We can have the reading of 100 ml here. The gas is sent at first to the KOH containing bulb. Now the stopcock to the atmosphere is closed and we have only dry flue gas here, and from where we will be calculating the amount of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, okay, and oxygen amount, and even nitrogen amount also we can calculate through this. So for that, what we do is at first we send the flue gas into the first bulb, which is containing KOH solution, and we know that KOH can absorb carbon dioxide. Then the difference in water level is being noted, and the change in water level will be equivalent to the amount of carbon dioxide absorbed by the KOH solution. So from this we can calculate the amount of carbon dioxide present in the flue gas. Then after that we send the gas into the second bulb, which is containing the alkaline pyrogalol solution. Alkaline pyrogalol solution can absorb carbon dioxide and oxygen. So, and after that, into the third bulb, which can absorb all the three gases. So, here what we are doing is we have already removed carbon dioxide. So, here in the second bulb, that is alkaline pyrogalol solution, though it can absorb both the gases, already carbon dioxide is removed, so it will give only the amount of oxygen. In the third bulb, which is containing ammonical cuprous chloride solution, it can absorb all the three gases, that is carbon dioxide, oxygen and carbon monoxide, but the bulb containing KOH solution already absorbed the amount of carbon dioxide present in the flue gas, and here the oxygen is also removed, and this will give the amount of carbon monoxide. So from the all these three bulbs, whenever we send the flue gas into these bulbs, second bulb we note the reading, change in reading, and in the third bulb also we see what is a change in the water level, that will give the amount of oxygen and carbon monoxide respectively. At first we calculated carbon dioxide, and from the second bulb we calculated the oxygen amount of oxygen, and from the third bulb we get the amount of carbon monoxide. The unabsorbed gas will be considered as the nitrogen. So we are having 100 ml here. From the 100 ml, whatever amount of carbon dioxide, oxygen, carbon monoxide has been calculated, that will be subtracted from 100. That will be the percentage of nitrogen present in the flue gas that will be sent. Thank you. That's all for today.